On today's show, we have Greg Liberto and his new company, A&A's Tree Service. Well, good morning, Buffalo, and welcome to Western New York at Work, where we talk about sports, jobs, economic development, and the people that make it happen. We also talk about where ideas and success come together. And with that being said, there's no better way than to talk about the family business, and where they talk about the family and customer focus. And there's one gentleman who I know who is the epitome of focus, and that's Mr. Greg Liberto. Greg, welcome back to Western New York at Work.
Thanks, Dale. Always a pleasure, and I appreciate the opportunity to be on the show again.
Greg, you do some amazing things, my friend, and your story is a testament of the two people that are right next to you. So let's talk about the two individuals that are your stars in your life.
Sure. So here to my left, we have my 11-year-old daughter, Addison, and over here, we have our little 8-year-old friend, Annalise.
Okay. Hello, ladies.
Hello. Hi.
How are you doing today?
Good.
Great. Fantastic. Well, it's my understanding. Well, first of all, I've been knowing your dad for a number of years, and he is an amazing guy, and I know that he is your superhero. But he has shared something with me about you two, and that you have inspired him to start a business. What's the name of their company?
A&A
Tree Service. Okay. Congratulations. So, Greg, okay, your daughters are going to outshine you, so I'm going to come back to you. So tell us a little bit about A&A's Tree Service.
Sure. So I had started working in the tree business for my brother about 40 years ago and did it a little bit in high school and throughout college. And as you well know, for the past 20 plus years or so, I've been in the corporate training and coaching space and always had this desire in the back of my mind to start a residential based business, but didn't really know what I wanted to do, wasn't interested in reinventing myself. But the way that it all happened, Dale, was very interesting and very organic. So last fall, I was in Elma. And I saw some trees on the front lawn of this particular house. And I just walked up and knocked on the door, introduced myself, and asked the homeowner, his name is Gary, if he was interested in having his trees removed on the property. So he said, you know, let me think about it. This was last October. So fast forward to mid-April of this year, he called me back. And he said, hey, Greg, I'm interested in having those trees removed. I said, great. So we went ahead and successfully did that, but I didn't really have a name for the company. You know, I was thinking about GL Tree Service, and I thought, you know, that's pretty boring. So I thought about what these two have been talking about. Now, granted, they're 8 and 11, and for the past couple of years, they've been kicking around this idea of starting their own restaurant. And they were going to call it A&A's Hangout. I said, A&A's Tree Service sounds a lot better than what I had in mind. So hence how the name was born.
Okay, fantastic. Now, Greg, one of the things that you did, which I find really remarkable, is that you did this during the time that there was a lot of uncertainty in the marketplace. Okay, you did this almost at the birth of, you know, the pandemic, and where other people were demotivated. You did something different. And so tell me a little bit more about that, because that's very remarkable to come up with a company, start a business during a downturn in the economy.
Yeah, no, good point, Dale, for sure. And what's really interesting is about a week before this all happened, I thought, you know what? This is probably the best time in history to be in door-to-door sales because everybody's home, right? Now, some people would completely disagree with that and say, oh, you know, you shouldn't be doing this during a time when everybody is home and we're not supposed to be, you know, quote unquote, in contact with each other. But my approach was, after Gary had said yes, I said, you know, let me knock on some more doors in the neighborhood. And other people were interested. Other people said yes. And I used that as my form of marketing. It's just really going door to door, introducing myself and letting people know about the services that I was offering. And more people said yes. So I looked at it as a tremendous opportunity to basically just get the word out about the company and, you know, bring some business in the door. And that's exactly what happened.
So great. Let's talk a little bit more about the business and why now? Why is this type of company very important in Western New York?
Well, tree removal and tree trimming, you know, for any homeowner can probably at some point say that they either had a tree they needed removed or trimmed, or has a tree that they need to remove or trim. And, you know, for anybody who does own a home, when you have a tree that's either hanging over your house or maybe a tree that looks a little more unsightly because it's lost its foliage, well, it's unfortunately time to do something about it. And I want to make it very clear, too, that yes, I'm in the business of trimming and removing trees, but I also love trees very much. So, you know, it's nice to be in a business where, you know, not only I can provide a great service and value to somebody, but it's also nice to be involved in a business that's completely different than what I've done in the past and, you know, provide a service that's enjoyable to me to provide. And like I said, I love trees. I love learning more and more about them each and every day. So yes, I started in the business 40 years ago, but as much as I thought I knew about running the business, I've been at it now for a few months only, but definitely learning more every single day and have met a lot of great people along the way already. And we're off to a great start.
Hey, fantastic. From an environmental standpoint, I mean, as a homeowner or for any and all homeowners or renters for that matter, what are some of the tips or what are some of the things that you see when you're driving around the community that individuals may not be aware of that they should be?
Sure. So great question, Dale. So one of the things with a healthy tree is to give it space. So there's a lot of times you'll see trees that are sort of intertwined with other ones, or maybe there's a larger tree that's hanging over a tree underneath it, not allowing it the proper sunlight or just basically the room to grow. So if you have a small pine underneath a large maple or whatever it is, you want to make sure that both of those trees have the opportunity to flourish. If they're competing with each other, one of them is eventually going to win out. Or there's also the aesthetic component of it. Maybe they just both need to be trimmed and allow a little more room for growth with both of them. But that's certainly one thing. The other is you want to make sure that any trees that are leaning towards the house are looked at and potentially removed, because that can be extremely dangerous. A limb that's hanging over the roof or a part of your house can also be very dangerous. And any type of a tree that has what appears to be some type of a disease or discoloration or dead branches in it probably needs to be looked at to see if it could be either trimmed properly and saved or if it might have to be removed.
Okay. All right. Fantastic. So that being said, Greg, do you have the opportunity to assess and look at a tree and whether it be immediately or to some degree determine what course of action needs to happen next? Not maybe it's not the tree, maybe it is, but the tricking of the tree, is that part of your service?
It absolutely is, Dale. Yep. So the thing that we're always going to do is look out in the best interest of the customer. I look at every tree as if I was a homeowner at that location. So my inclination is to do whatever we can to save it, to improve the the health of it. Obviously, make sure that the safety of everybody at the home is there as well. But I'm of the mindset of, okay, what can we do to beautify the tree, the property as well, and make sure that the tree is healthy as possible. So again, I'm looking at it as if I'm the homeowner and saying, okay, well, what's the best course of action here, and whatever that is. And, you know, sometimes it's a conversation between both of, you know, here's an idea that I might throw out. They might throw out something back, and then we come to some kind of a compromise. But every situation is very, very different. So anytime somebody is thinking about doing something with the tree, you know, you can't just send me a picture and let's, you know, figure it out from there. It's always, you know, an in-person free estimate to come out and have a discussion about it.
Okay. And that being said, Greg, for anyone that is, you know, in need of, you know, taking a look at the trees in the surrounding areas, how can they contact you? What is your contact information?
799-TREE.
716-799-TREE. Okay. Say it again.
799-TREE.
Very good. And, it really cements what the company is about. So a very identifiable telephone number. Again, 716-799-TREE. Buffalo, we're going to take a very short break. And when we come back, we're going to hear from Greg, Addison, and Annalise talk about more about ANA's tree service.
Hi, I'm Lauren Lewis, and I hope you're all doing well. Today, I wanted to talk to you guys a little bit about networking and give some networking tips. Now, networking sometimes can have this negative connotation, like, oh my gosh, I have to go to this networking event. I have to talk to people about who I am and what I do and learn about what they are, who they are and what they do. But networking doesn't have to be such a formal event. And right now, you know, networking really is a powerful tool considering the time we're living in and there's a lot of uncertainty going on. So you want to make sure you're always building your network. It's always important to build those connections so that you are meeting new people. It's great to learn new things. You can talk to different people from different backgrounds and in different career paths and learn about them, and you gain different knowledge, which is super helpful in helping to continue to mold your path. It's also great for career advancement and new career opportunities. So, you know, I really wanted to encourage that. It's take away the negative connotation of it. It can be a really fun thing, and it does not have to be a black and white formal networking event you go to in order to network. Network can really be done anywhere. You can network at a restaurant. You can network at a place of worship. You can network at your kids' sporting events. Networking can be done really anywhere. Now, especially in this day and age that we're living in, where so much is being done virtually, you can network virtually from the comfort and safety of your own home, which is super nice. You don't have to go anywhere for it. And there's a lot of different networking events that are done online. And it's a great tool to meet new people while a lot of us are kind of stuck at home. And networking is really more important than ever right now. It should not be done only when you need something. You should always be networking and meeting new people and learning about new things so that when you do need something, your network is already in place. So my goal today with you guys was just to talk a little bit about networking and take away that negative connotation of it and let you know that it can be fun. It can be what you want it to be, and not to always feel like it's a forced thing that you have to do in order to get your next job or your next opportunity or your next promotion. Networking should always be done before you even need something, and it can be done anywhere. I've met some really great people out at different restaurants and at church, at sporting events, and it will then take away the formal black and white negative connotation of networking when you think about it that way. So always be networking, continue to grow your network, meet new people, offer up something to people that you meet. I'm sure you have a lot to offer everyone out there and they can learn something from you. So be sure to offer that up as well. And I know that you'll continue to grow your network and continue to be successful in your career just by having fun with it. Have a good day.
Western New York at Work is brought to you by our key business partners and many business professionals.
Bocce's Club Pizza, Staff Buffalo, Buffalo Healthy Living, CAI, Hope Buffalo, Embassy Suites, 716 Limousine.
Freedom. It's at the core of who we are. The freedom to live without fear, to jog where we please, to wear a hoodie. The freedom to breathe. Before we celebrate the freedom most Americans have, we must fight for the freedom all Americans deserve. Because all lives can't matter until Black lives matter.
Three months ago, there weren't enough masks. We were desperately sourcing from all over the world. People were making face coverings from scarves, bandanas, and bits of fabric. Now there are plenty of masks, but some people don't want to wear them. Come on. Be New York tough. Mask up, America.
I know what you're thinking. I need a job.
I need a new career.
Well, I've been there.
I've been there.
I've been there. I wasn't happy with what I was doing.
After high school, I didn't have a plan.
I just wanted to start working.
I got laid off twice. But you gotta keep going.
You just need the right skills. Find an apprenticeship.
I found a two-year IT program.
I found a medical course online.
I'm now a consultant in the tech space.
You have more options than you think. You can do this.
You will find something.
You will find something new.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows? Maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome. We need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
Welcome back to West New York at Work, Buffalo, where we're talking to Greg Liberto. And Greg is with his two beautiful daughters, and they started a company, ANA's Tree Service. Greg, so let's talk a little bit more about the company and maybe homeowners need to know that maybe we just take for granted.
Sure. So one of the things, Dale, is, you know, a lot of homeowners who feel confident running a chainsaw might look at a broken limb or a relatively smaller tree and say, you know what, I think I can handle this on my own. So I just want to share a couple of tips to keep in mind if you're going to do that. So first and foremost is, number one, make sure you wear a helmet and safety glasses. Tree trimming, tree removal is a very dangerous job. There's a lot of things that can go wrong. It's not just the limbs that are falling out of the tree, but there's limbs on the ground. It's easy to fall and trip, and you know, with a chainsaw in your hand, that can be pretty dangerous. So first and foremost, if you decide to remove a tree or a portion of your tree on your own, I highly, highly recommend to wear a helmet and safety glasses. The other thing is a lot of, I shouldn't say a lot, some homeowners are at a point where they say, okay, well, you know, I think I can do it on my own. Might be a little out of my league, so to speak, or out of my area of expertise. Should I bring in the experts and just maybe get a free estimate and see what their thoughts are? My response to that is to always err on the side of caution. So make the phone call, right? So even if you decide after you speak to us or whoever you're going to bring in that, you know, I am going to take this down on my own, or I am going to hire somebody like us, you're going to have much more peace of mind for sure. If you are going to do it on your own, make sure you take the necessary safety precautions. But if you feel there's a sliver of doubt that maybe it's a little bit out of your league, certainly give us a call. We'd be happy to come out and give a free estimate.
Okay. And again, that telephone number is
716-799-TREE.
799-TREE. I love that. Very easy to remember. Are there any types of trees that can't be moved or can't be touched, or are there any federal or state regulations?
Well, we cannot touch anything that's on the external side of a homeowner sidewalk. That's always the city or town or village property that they're in. And there are certain trees that are going away. So, for example, the ash trees, you know, as a lot of people know, there's the emerald ash borer that has come through and literally like wiped out almost the entire species of ash tree. So if you have an ash tree today that has some foliage on it, the likelihood of it being dead in another year or two is very high. So and a lot of them are very large in size. Again, if they're leaning towards the house, extremely dangerous. So anybody who has an ash tree on their property, definitely want to be proactive with that, because you know, there's a lot of times where a tree might not look as if it's a potential danger or a threat, but if it's rotted from the inside out, it could potentially fall at any time. So if you have ash trees on your property, you certainly want to be proactive about that.
And in terms of number of employees and expansion, can you share with us, I mean, you know, what it requires to be in the business and what type of employment opportunities exist?
Sure. So we have a crew of four currently, Dale, myself included. We are looking to grow the business. So we are looking for an experienced tree climber, somebody who has expertise in both trimming and removing trees, whether they're climbing the tree or working out of a bucket or aerial lift. We're certainly in need of that service. And we are looking to add another person on the ground to help us get rid of the trees as well. So yes, we are definitely looking for a couple of key people to add to the team. And you know, we're young, we're all about safety and customer focus, as you had mentioned. So somebody who has good communication skills, comfortable in speaking with individuals is certainly a good fit. And somebody who is also a good fit to work with the other team members. So we're all about communication.
And going back to that experience, is experience required?
For the person, for somebody who's a tree climber, absolutely. For somebody who's looking to work with us on the ground, we can certainly train in that skill set. But yes, anybody who's looking to help us remove the trees or actually take down the trees, we require at least 2 to 5 years experience for sure.
Okay. All right. And Greg, I'll just add to this so that you can share with our audience whether this is true or not. If you have a passion and have worked in any type of lawn care, this could be an ideal career for you, because you bring you already have a sense of working in gardening, and now you're just expanding your knowledge base.
Sure. Yep. Yeah. It's similar to people working in the landscaping industry in the respect that you're outside all day. You're used to working in the extreme heat and sometimes cold weather. But you're also accustomed to just, you know, working at, you know, a property owner's site, being cordial, you know, again, positive communication, clean communication along the way, and working with other team members as well. So somebody that's working in the landscaping industry currently could be a good fit for us.
Okay. And once again, if you're looking for treatment, or removal, that telephone number is
716-799-TREE. And you can find us on Facebook at facebook.com/716-799-TREE.
Tree. Okay, fantastic. Greg, before we sign off, I have to ask the young ladies a very, very important question. And that is, what is your favorite sport?
Basketball.
Yeah. Basketball. Okay. Oh, two basketball players. Okay.
I know it's not Western New York at Work related, but maybe for a future show, we could have the girls from St. Mark's basketball team, this being one of them, talk about their championship season this past year, and maybe bring the entire team on.
I was going to say, rumor has it that we have some championship players here.
And a team mascot as well.
And team mascot. Okay, fantastic. Well, Greg, Addison and Annalise, thank you so much for being a part of Western New York at Work. This has been a great experience for me. I'm so thrilled to meet you ladies. Congratulations, even a third or fourth time, on helping your dad start a new company with your ideas, your creativity, and bring it all together. A family business with a customer focus. Have a wonderful day, and I look forward to our next conversation. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Dale.
Thank you.
Western New York at Work is brought to you by our key business partners and many business professionals.
Bocce's Club Pizza, Staff Buffalo, Buffalo Healthy Living, CAI, Hope Buffalo, Embassy Suites, 716 Limousine.
Freedom. It's at the core of who we are. The freedom to live without fear, to jog where we please, to wear a hoodie. The freedom to breathe. Before we celebrate the freedom most Americans have, we must fight for the freedom all Americans deserve. Because all lives can't matter until Black lives matter.
Three months ago, there weren't enough masks. We were desperately sourcing from all over the world. People were making face coverings from scarves, bandanas, and bits of fabric. Now there are plenty of masks, but some people don't want to wear them. Come on. Be New York tough. Mask up, America.
I know what you're thinking. I need a job.
I need a new career.
Well, I've been there.
I've been there.
I've been there. I wasn't happy with what I was doing.
After high school, I didn't have a plan.
I just wanted to start working.
I got laid off twice. But you gotta keep going.
You just need the right skills. Find an apprenticeship.
I found a two-year IT program.
I found a medical course online.
I'm now a consultant in the tech space.
You have more options than you think. You can do this.
You will find something.
You will find something new.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows, maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome, we need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
Maybe you can make retirement happen. After all, you made home ownership happen. Homeschooling yourself on loans, beefing up your credit score.
So I'm pre-approved.
You were like, yes! Sorry. Color coding listings, ticking boxes, and flushing every toilet in a 20-mile radius. Home sweet home. You aced house hunting. Now get the tips you need to get on track at aceyourretirement.org.